Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video isn't a figure review or anything. It is actually a top 10 video on my top 10 favorite Queen Amidala figures. As you guys all know, Padme, Queen Amidala, is my all-time favorite Star Wars character. So I just wanted to do a top 10 favorite figures of her. I already did a top 10 favorite Padme figures on my channel. I may do another one of that, because, you know, my top 10s always change. I'm not sure yet, but I just wanted to do, Queen Amidala, from episode 1. A lot of people in the past have gotten a mistake between Queen Amidala and, Padme, and they think they're totally different characters, but actually, Queen Amidala is Padme, and Padme is Queen Amidala. They're the same character. She does have decoys, like Sebe and Rebe. And Sebe, is her decoy, so she dresses up as her a lot. So that probably confuse people. So I'm just gonna go into the list, and we're gonna start with number 10. Number 10 is episode 1, 1999, Senate gown, Queen Amidala. This was one of the first Queen Amidala figures, actually I think the first ever Queen Amidala figures, that was released from episode 1, which for the time, it was pretty good, and it's still pretty good, in my opinion. But I love all of, like, Padme's hairstyles and stuff, out of all of them, this is not one of my favorites, you know. I still like it, it's just not one of my favorites. But I love the effect where it looks like it's dragging, and she would be great for, like, dioramas and stuff like that, if you ever need a Queen Amidala for a diorama. So that is number 10. Number 9 is another 1999 version, and this was the second release of the Padme in her wedding, or not her wedding, her battle dress. And this one came with her zipline gun, or whatever you want to call it, what she uses to get up to the top of the palace in episode 1. And instead of her dress being plastic, it is soft goods. So she's good, because then she can sit down. And if you have any ships and like that, you can put her in the ship. Which, if I ever get any ships, I may do that. I kind of want another one to open to do that if I ever get another ship. I want two more. Another one to open, and another one to keep guarded. Her articulation isn't the best. The likeness to Natalie Portman isn't the best either, but it's an okay figure. I heard this one was a little tougher to find back then. I only saw her a few times on eBay. A friend helped me get her. Number 8 is, now this is not Queen Amidala, it's Sebe, but seeing as she is in Queen Amidala outfit, I always count her as a Queen Amidala figure. They do come, there is another Sebe figure in her battle uniform, but yeah, just note, this is not Padme in this outfit. It is Keira Knightley, or Sebe, she played Sebe. But for this came out in The Power of the Jedi, it only has 3 points of articulation: shoulders, arms, and under her gown, her waist. So if you're an articulation freak, I'm not, you probably wouldn't like this figure, but the detail is really nice, actually, the ruffles on her gown. When I first got this figure, I was really upset, because I saw pictures of the Naboo symbols. They were bright gold, and mine aren't. They're a little gold. They have very, very, you know, then you can't see them really well. So, yeah, but it's still a great figure. The likeness to Keira Knightley, it's hard to tell, because she has white makeup on, but I think it looks a lot like her. the detail on her head is pretty nice too, and feathers. I would have loved to seen an updated version of this figure, in the vintage line or something. So yes. Number 7 is another Padme in her battle gown. And this is the first ever Padme figure we got in her battle dress. And I like it much better than the original, the first one I showed you. This is another one I would like to get carded, or at least again, because some paint's coming off her hair. I found it at a swap meet for a quarter, and she was loose. Some paint's coming off her hand. But the detail is pretty nice on her dress. You know, and the likeness, in my opinion, I think it looks a lot like Natalie Portman. It's pretty good. So yeah, this is another one I really actually want to get again. So pretty, one of the better figures for 1999. There actually weren't too many bad figures in 1999. Number 6 is Queen Amidala in her travel gown. And this figure is from the Legacy Collection. And she came out in 2009, and I was so excited when I got her. I passed up the hologram Darth Sidious for her, just because, you know, she's been my favorite character for years. And yeah, so I got her when she first came out. Pretty good detail. Again, she doesn't have very much articulation. She has really no movement in her head. Swivel in the waist, swivel in the ball jointed shoulders, and ball hinged elbows. So a few ball joints there. The detail on her is pretty nice. The hood. The likeness to Natalie Portman, they're kind of missing the white makeup, which they had that problem before. But yeah, it's a pretty good figure. So there's number 5. Another harder one to find, I hear. I haven't seen her on eBay that much. Number 4. Number, 5. Actually, that was number 6. Sorry. This is number 5. It is the newest Padme in her battle uniform from the movie Heroes Wave 2. It just came out last year. The detail on her is pretty nice. It's a great update to the first two we got. The hair is pretty nice too. Again, I was super excited when I found this. You can ask all my friends that had it and I wanted it. The face sculpt, it looks like Natalie Portman, but it looks like an older version of her. She doesn't look 14 here. She comes with a blaster. Her articulation is still not the best. She has a ball-jointed head, swivel in the shoulders, ball-hinged elbows, swivel in the waist, and swivel in the hips. They could have gave her ball-hinged knees, but it's not a big deal. Still a good, nice figure. So that's number 5. Number 4 is Queen Amidala in the Senate, post-Senate outfit. This figure came in the Padme Amidala Evolutions pack. Really nice figure. Really nice detail on her dress. Again, I love that effect where it's dragging. Her hair is just long. Pretty nice. She has shoes on. Her headdress is nice and detailed. The face sculpt to Natalie Portman, I see it in there. It's pretty good. So, yeah, she has articulation, you know, ball hinged, swivel in the head, ball hinged elbows, shoulders, and ball hinged elbows, and swivel in the waist. So that is number 5. Number 4. Number 3 is the post-Senate Queen Amidala from the Vintage Collection. Pretty good one. I was really excited for this one coming out last year. Nice detail on her. She has actually really good articulation. She has a ball-hinged head, ball-hinged shoulders, ball-hinged elbows, swivel in the waist. The likeness to Natalie Portman is pretty spot-on, in my opinion, for a Queen Amidala figure. And just great detail overall. Number 2 is the Throne Room Queen Amidala, and I just reviewed her on my channel. She's a really special figure to me because I got her with a friend that I who no longer talk to anymore. She got into drugs and stuff, and so yeah, and I reviewed her on my channel, so you can check her out. And then number one is my favorite Queen Amidala. Again, I talk about her. The detail is just great on her dress, the celebration gown. The face sculpt is great. Just they could have added the white makeup, and it would have been perfect. And it's still a perfect figure, in my opinion. She comes with the Globe of Peace. So yeah, just a beautiful figure. So that is my top 10 favorite Queen Amidala figures. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. And as always, may the force be with you. Bye.